For a very long time, Plasma and Tilink extensions have been in a very weird state. Early on with X11, you didn't need an extension because you could just swap out the window manager with anything you wanted. You want to use i3, BSPWM, DWM, awesome, go ahead and do so. Regardless, extensions did start to appear though. Initially, there was quite a few of them. And then some of them fell off, they didn't keep getting updated. Eventually, there was just one, that being Bismuth. But by the time that Plasma 6 came around, the only one you had was Polonium. Now, thankfully, one of the old extensions did get revived, that being Cronkite, so now on Plasma, you have the option of using two of them. But don't worry, this whole idea of whether your workflow is actually going to function or not also exists in Gnome Land as well. Now, when I'm talking about tiling, I want to be very clear what I actually mean, because certain projects and certain desktops have this really annoying goal of making the term that before was perfectly clear as annoying as possible. I'm looking at you, the Plasma Tiling Editor. When I say tiling extension, I mean replicating the behavior of a tiling window manager. You spawn a window, it is automatically placed into a tile. If all you want is customizable window snapping, more akin to something like fancy zones on Windows or the tiling editor on Plasma, there are plenty of options. And again, this is what I mean about people making the terminology needlessly confusing. There are things like tiling assistant, awesome tiles, tiling shell, and wind tile. None of these are actually tiling, and in the description, talk about snapping, and when you play around with them, they're doing snapping, not tiling. That's a topic for a separate video though. If you don't want tiling and what you want is snapping, I believe all of these extensions are working on the newest version of GNOME. But if we're talking about actual tiling like that being used in a tiling window manager on GNOME, you've really only had two extensions to work with. The first one being PopShell. Now, the problem with PopShell is it was only actively being developed for the version of GNOME that PopOS was shipping, because this was being developed by the PopOS team for use in PopOS. There is a branch being worked on for a newer version of Ubuntu, but for the most part, you basically just had to be happy with whatever Ubuntu LTS that PopOS was basing off of, which meant if you wanted the newest GNOME features, you kinda weren't gonna be able to do so without using the experimental development branch. So a lot of people instead began opting for another extension, that being Forge. Now, I've not had a chance to properly sit down and mess around with Forge, but every time that somebody asks about a GNOME tiling extension, half the comments are about snapping. Those people didn't understand the assignment. The other half of the comments usually say, just go and use Forge. It seems like most people that want tiling in GNOME think Forge is a pretty good extension. Think that it's nice that it works on modern versions of GNOME and isn't just being developed for what System 76 wants on their system. There are obviously going to be issues, every project has issues, but this seems to be the generally recommended go-to. There's a problem though. Forge is not maintained anymore. It is looking for a new owner and maintainer. And PopShell is in a very similar state. Just a few days ago, a user by the name of Malix Labs has a couple of questions. PopShell Future. Hello. Since PopOS default desktop environment seems to plan switching from GNOME to Cosmic eventually, basically what's gonna happen? Is PopShell still officially maintained? If yes, until when? It is still maintained as part of PopOS 22.04 LTS. It is not being maintained for 24.04 LTS, and support for the GNOME 42, which 22.04 LTS ship with, will end when 22.04 LTS becomes end of life, which is April 2027 to match Ubuntu. There is a development branch that does support the 24.04 LTS. but it is a development branch and it's not really the main focus anymore, and nobody's touched it in quite a while. What is the planned future of PopShow? System 76 is not currently putting development resources into adapting PopShow to newer GNOME versions. For the time being, we're happy to accept contributions from anyone who wants to help keep it working after GNOME updates, with minimal quality assurance barriers for GNOME versions that do not impact PopOS. There's currently no plan for PopShow beyond that. With Cosmic being the new shiny desktop coming from System 76 and it being the thing they want to ship on PopOS, this is something you should have expected to happen, but I don't believe there was ever, like, an official announcement of this being the case. And the last thing is the PopShell's proposal about upstreaming to GNOME still active. Honestly, I was not aware of this ever happening in the first place. No. As far as I'm aware, the upstream GNOME team is not interested in implementing something as complex as PopShow. They are, of course, welcome to use our code under the open source license, but we've always had to put in a lot of work to keep up with the latest GNOME changes, and PopShow has some problems on newer versions of GNOME that have not shipped in PopOS. There were talks a few years ago at GWADEC about a tiling system in GNOME. I don't believe that was ever going to be based on what PopShow was doing, but there's at least a couple of people in that team interested in seeing what can be done, at least like prototyping something. So we'll see what ends up happening with that direction, if anything ever ends up happening. As for Forge's message, this is kind of a long time coming. In September of 2023, looking for a new maintainer. Hello. First of all, thank you everyone for your support. I'm looking for a new maintainer of this extension. It has been a lot of fun, lots of learning, issues of course, and will not go away, but priorities change and life goes on. For anyone who likes to step up, you can find me on the GNOME Matrix Room. I will set you up on the process. And originally the plan was to archive the repo come January of 2024. Now, like happens in a lot of cases with a popular extension, there are people here who are like, hey, I'd be willing to do it, but I don't have that much coding knowledge, I'm new to programming. Yeah, okay, I could help out a bit if someone else was gonna help out. There's one person here who's like, yeah, I'd be willing to step up as a maintainer. But, you know, maintaining someone else's code base is always a bit of a challenge. It is very rare that a project actually gets handed off from one maintainer over to another. I know we all like to say, ooh, if a project dies, it can just be forked, but yes, that can happen, but there are so many other projects out there that that never happens to. A project dies, and it kinda just stays dead. So considering the message on the repo, you can probably guess what happened by the time January of 2024 came around. Still looking for a new maintainer, January 2nd, 2024. Hi there, happy new year. Hoping for a new maintainer. As most you may have seen, I had put in the announcement for a new maintainer. That hasn't changed. Adding this ticket for visibility. I also talked to Javid, Just Perfection, about the transition plan. And again, some people were willing to step up, review patches, and some people are like new to doing GNOME extensions and all this. As I said, taking over a big project like this, it's gonna be very difficult to find someone unless you find someone whilst you're still actively working on things. Like W Roots is a really good example of this. The reason that got handed over from Drew DeVault over to Simon Sir is Simon was a big maintainer whilst Drew was still working on the project, and he felt comfortable handing over the project when he stepped away. The Linux kernel was in a very similar situation. It started with Linus, but then other people stepped up, started doing a lot of work, and you don't want to wait for this to happen till you don't want to keep working on it any longer, because that's not the time you're gonna find people that you really think are comfortable in the code base. But he did change his mind about archiving the extension. Instead, what he's gonna do is keep it around, let people review PRs, let people make PRs, and if people are new to extensions, here's where you can go and help out and learn this stuff. And if some existing contributors want to take on more work, they can absolutely go and do so. But doing this is probably better than having like a million different forks spawn up where there's just like one-off developers doing little things here and there. It keeps everything in the same place, keeping it quite a bit easier to manage if somebody else does want to say, I'm going to do this, I'm actually going to step up. Now, here's the funny thing. Over on the Cosmic discussion, the person answering all these questions also directed people over to Forge as a replacement for PopShell. They didn't know that Forge also wasn't really in a good state for maintainership. And when this happened, the maintainer of Forge also chimed in here as well. Hey Malix, I still use my extension. It's at least stable for my daily use. I think it will still be usable for a very long time unless the upstream GNOME team changes their API. With that said, I can keep up with the new versions of GNOME Shell so it gets released to EGO for those who do not code or can't build themselves, but any breaking changes, I might not have the time to make updates. For what it's worth, I think the biggest change from GNOME upstream was converting to import/exports module. So it's in this like half maintainership state where, look, if he tries Cosmic and it's actually really good, it is entirely possible he does completely drop this. But right now, it might keep getting updated, but there's no guarantee you're going to see it as soon as the new version of GNOME comes out, and maybe it's only going to be like a month or so later whenever he decides to update on his system. So it's something where you can't guarantee it's going to be there. So GNOME people, you also get to experience this real fun state of just not really knowing whether the extension you want actually is still going to exist. This is why I'm not really a big fan of relying on extensions for things. Extensions are nice in cases where they sort of iron out some of the rough edges, but if I need an extension for a desktop to actually be usable for me, I don't particularly want to use that desktop then. I can tolerate floating, right? I don't like it, I don't want to use it, but I can tolerate it. If you actually need a Tyler to just be remotely functional, you might want to start looking for something new. However, if you're willing to adapt your workflow to a tiling esque pattern, a tiling esque extension where it's not tiling in the sense of a tiling window manager, windows are still being tiled and it does have active maintainers. That extension being PaperWM. This turns GNOME into a scrollable window manager. Basically, the idea is instead of having your screen and then a bunch of workspaces, you have this infinitely expanding horizontal plane, and you can scroll along that. Windows get automatically placed into the layout, and you can move them around like it is a tiler, resize them like it is a tiler, and not have to worry about like losing windows being behind other things. So it kind of acts similar enough to a tiler where for a lot of people, this would be a reasonable equivalent. But hey, if you really want Forge and you really want PopShell to stick around, this seems like as good a time as any to just take up development of GNOME extensions. I'm not going to do so. I'm not a GNOME user. This disappearing doesn't really affect me. But if you are someone who is affected and you have any passing interest in development and you want to help out a project that you very actively use, this is a good time to do so. But hey, if you don't want to do that and you don't have that skill set, maybe now is as good a time as any to try out another desktop. Whether it's KDE, whether you want to try out the Cosmic Alpha, whether you want to go try out a window manager, just see what's out there. See if there's something you like. If there's not, well, I don't know. I don't know what you can do then. That's a problem you got to deal with at that point. But I'm sure there's something out there for you. Surely. If there is another extension that should be recommended that I wasn't aware of, please let me know in the comment section down below, especially if it's a tiling extension. If there is a proper tiling extension I'm not aware of that's actually good, I will probably pin it. But I don't think there is one. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of These amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Liberapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and...
Surely you can find something good.